For Vali Cruz, it's simple things like getting her girls ready for school that she'll never take for granted.
That's enough snacks for you.
Diagnosed with ovarian cancer, first at 19 and again at 24, surgeries to remove both her ovaries saved her life, but took away her chances of conceiving.
I didn't think I would ever have kids after the second diagnosis. So I'm pretty lucky. I say I'm the luckiest unlucky person you'll know.
So this is one of our tanks where we keep the ovarian tissue.
It was a procedure pioneered by Professor Kate Stern that changed her fortunes. With no time to preserve eggs, Vali's ovarian tissue had been frozen instead.
So this is where the potential lies.
She was the first to have those grafts implanted outside the pelvis in the abdomen, resulting in a successful IVF pregnancy and twins, Alexis and Kaya.
Waited patiently for the first scan. We were all crying. And they called Kate and she was crying. That was just the first little black hole that they saw on the screen. And she moved the probe and then there was another one.
Vali was, she worked so hard though. It took a lot of time. This is not a one-hit wonder.
Professor Stern now hopes to take the process a step further and use ovarian grafts to grow viable eggs outside the body. If achieved, it could mature hundreds of eggs rather than one or two per month and would be safer for patients.
What we would like to be able to do is to be able to get more potential for our patients from their ovarian tissue.
Her team hopes to offer the procedure to selected patients as part of clinical research within the next 12 months before it's made routinely available.
And I hope that somewhere between the next 2 and 5 years, the fertility scientific community will have nailed this.
While using ovarian grafts is now well established for cancer patients, whether they should be used for people who are healthy is prompting scientific debate. Yale's Professor Kutluk Oktay is another industry pioneer. He's led a study showing the procedure could be used to delay menopause for decades.
So menopause is part of aging, reproductive aging. It's not a condition, but when it happens, it brings with it many problems for a lot of women, not every woman.
According to his modelling, tissue frozen from a 40-year-old would delay menopause by a median 3.4 years, while tissue from a 21-year-old could delay it by 19.4 years. This is assuming just one implant, but the procedure can be repeated.
About 11% of women experience late menopause after age 55. And we have data from these women. They have a lot of health benefits. You know, they have less bone loss, cardiovascular diseases, dementia, anxiety, depression. Our current position is that if there's a way to delay menopause to the limits, the upper limit of normal range, then I think women would benefit from this.
Professor Oktay says his team will continue to collect data, but believes we know enough to justify freezing tissue now. For Professor Stern, the potential benefits don't yet outweigh the risks.
The bigger question of whether it's safe and the right thing to do to preserve female hormones well into the 60s is not answered yet. So I'm not discounting the possibility, but I would like to see more research into the safety of preserving reproductive hormones in the long term using tissue.
In the meantime, medical breakthroughs are bringing hope to women who've already been through so much.
They don't think your children ever appreciate it, do they?
We do!
Totally.
Sarah Conti, SBS World News.